plains of Babylon, where he sat down, and where he went, when he remembered Zion. Oh, how the wicked carry us away in captivity, requiring from us a song. Yeah. How can we sing King Alpha's song in a strange land?
One Gospel, Version 2, Part 1. This is the fifth supplement for the preface. Seeing that many have taken in hand to set in order a narrative of those things which have been fulfilled among us, even as they, who from the beginning were eyewitnesses and servants of the word, delivered them to us. So let's look at the many. Who were the many that had taken in hand to set in order a narrative before Luke had written his gospel? So, when we look at the four gospels that are in the Christian Bible, you have Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. Were Matthew and Mark already written? Were they two of the ones that were the many? Holly, why don't you read this quote? Among the four Gospels, which are the only indisputable ones in the Church of God under heaven, I have learned by tradition that the first was written by Matthew, who was once a publican, but afterwards an apostle of Jesus Christ, and it was prepared for the converts from Judaism and published in the Hebrew language. The second is by Mark, who composed it according to the instructions of Peter, who in his Catholic epistle acknowledges him as a son, saying, "The church that is at Babylon, elected together with you, saluteth you, and so doth Marcus my son." And the third by Luke, the gospel commended by Paul, and composed for Gentile converts, last of all that by John. So this is Eusebius, the first church historian, quoting Origen, who was a church father in Alexandria who lived before him. So this says that Matthew was written first. It says that John was written last. It says that Luke, his gospel was commended by Paul. And it kind of indicates that Mark could have been written before Luke by calling it the second and saying that Mark was written according to the instructions of Peter. Now, that at least gives us an indication that Matthew and Mark may have already been written. But maybe Matthew was the only one already written. Here's another quote for you. You want to read that one, Holly?
Again, in the same books, Clement gives the tradition of the earliest presbyters as to the order of the Gospels in the following manner. The Gospels containing the genealogies, he says, were written first. The Gospel, according to Marx, had this occasion. As Peter had preached the word publicly at Rome and declared the Gospel by the Spirit, many who were present requested that Mark, who had followed him out for a long time and remembered his sayings, should write them out. And having composed the Gospel, he gave it to those who had requested it. When Peter learned of this, he neither directly forbade nor encouraged it. The last of all, John, perceiving that the external facts had been made plain in the gospel, being urged by his friends, inspired by the Spirit, composed a spiritual gospel. Eusebius, Church History, Book 6, Chapter 14, quoting Clement.
So Clement lived before Origen, although they were from the same area of Alexandria. And so Eusebius, who, again, the first church historian, quoting Clement, seems to indicate that Matthew and Luke, because they were the two Gospels containing the genealogies, were written first. And then Mark was written after. But Clement agrees that John was written last. So when Luke says many had already written, we at least have church history supporting that Matthew was already written, but we have inconsistent church history about Mark. And we have consistent church history that John had not been written yet. So, is Luke's gospel the gospel Paul declared? Because that would help us in dating the gospel of Luke. Holly, why don't you read the next quote?
Matthew published his gospel among the Hebrews in their own language, while Peter and Paul were preaching and founding the church at Rome. After their departure, Mark, the disciple and interpreter of Peter, also transmitted to us in writing those things which Peter had preached. And Luke, the attendant of Paul, recorded in a book the gospel which Paul had declared. Afterwards, John, the disciple of the Lord, who also reclined on his bosom, published his gospel while staying at Ephesus in Asia. He states these things in the third book of his above-mentioned work, Eusebius, Church History, Book 5, Chapter 8, quoting Irenaeus.
Now, Irenaeus lived even before Clement and Origen. So again, we have a quote of an early church father. And it gives the indication that the book that Mark wrote and that Luke wrote was after their departure, meaning after their death. So let's keep that in mind. However, when we remember that Luke says, well, I had my sources, well, his sources were probably the same sources that Paul had when Paul was spreading the gospel. So another question is, well, did Luke know people beyond Paul? So, Holly, why don't you read this last quote for us?
But Luke, who was of Antiochian parentage and a physician by profession, and who was especially intimate with Paul and well acquainted with the rest of the apostles, has left us, in two inspired books, proofs of that spiritual healing art which he learned from them. One of these books in the gospel which he testifies that he wrote as those who were from the beginning eyewitnesses and ministers of the word delivered unto him, all of whom, as he says, he followed accurately from the first. The other book is the Acts of the Apostles, which he composed not from the accounts of others, but from what he had seen himself. And they say that Paul meant to refer to Luke's gospel whenever, as if speaking of some gospel of his own. He used the words, according to my gospel. Eusebius, Church History, Book 3, Chapter 4.6.
So, if you look at Paul's uses of the word, my gospel, it is found in the book of Romans and 2 Timothy. And he also uses the phrase our gospel in 2 Corinthians, 1 Thessalonians, and 2 Thessalonians. So, now Eusebius is not giving a source. He says, and they say that Paul meant to refer to Luke's gospel. So this is what you would call someone recording an oral tradition. But Luke, at least according to oral tradition, not only knew Paul, but he also knew many of the other apostles as sources, and that the book must have been written actually before many of Paul's epistles were written. So that would place it very early. So these are things that you should keep in mind. However, we can say, though, that Luke had many sources, and that when he wrote his gospel, many of them were already in circulation. Thanks. So let the word